My name is Hanna Mikkola, and I work at the University of California, Los Angeles. And I'm a professor here at the Department of Molecular Cell and Developmental Biology and the Broad Stem Cell Research Center. And I've been a group leader here for 10 years now. My lab works on understanding how to develop better treatments for leukemia. If you think about the reason why I became a scientist, I think I could track back it to when I was a child. And I read in some magazine about a child with leukemia. And you see, she had lost her hair. They talked about the taking the bone marrow aspirate, how that was painful, and how the medications made her sick. And I was just devastated. I was really afraid of leukemia. But it's almost like if how to make your enemy to a friend, you need to get to know it better. So that was sort of the reason why I pursued, I wanted to go to med school. I wanted to become a hematologist to treat leukemia. I wanted to get closer to this problem that had made me so devastated. And I think that's still why I'm in this path. So I'm originally from Finland. That's where I went to med school. When I was in medical school, it became obvious for me that we didn't have all the key understanding that we need to treat the patient. So how can you cure a disease if you don't know why this disease developed in the first place? So I just felt that we need to understand more. And for me to be able to help in this big mission is to be in the research side and really try to understand the origins of the disease. So what we hope to accomplish with the research in our lab is that we could create in a culture dish a perfect blood stem cell that we could take and transplant into patients that need this treatment for leukemias or sickle cell anemia or some other fatal blood disease. And we really hope that there is no more barriers of that the patient cannot be treated with this curative treatment because there's no available a donor who could give their blood stem cells. And I believe that with all the new technologies and the progress that has been made in this field, that we will get there one day. Life in the lab, it has its many different parts. Of course, the important thing is that you need to do experiments. You need to have a question and you design your experiment. How would I answer this question? You design your controls, you design what you do, you make your calculation, then you go do your experiment. But often people think that that's where it ends. No, that's where it starts. When the results come, that's where the fun part starts, when you can really try to think about what does this mean. In the lab, we have students and trainees at all levels. We've had high school students. We have many college undergraduates who work at the same time as their studies. We have, of course, PhD students and postdocs. And I think what is important that you don't have to have a fancy title to be able to make a discovery. Anybody who wants to do this can do this. And in my own experience, I was a med school student. I was there doing my first sequencing gel of a blood coagulation, a patient who had a blood coagulation disease. And one day I looked at the gel and I was the first one in the whole world who knew what mutation this patient had. And I just thought it was amazing. I wasn't a professor, I wasn't even close to be a PhD, but I could be there to make the discovery. And that's why what I want everybody to know that it's there for you as well.